In today's video, I am going to show you how to install and use a desktop in Termix but without using Proot. This way we can have a better performance on the desktop, although the functionality is more limited because we cannot install all the programs we would like as we can do in Debian. I will also show you how to install Chromium to browse with a desktop browser and how to customize the whole environment as you like. The first thing will be to open Termix and also my GitHub repository that I have updated with all the information that I am going to show you in this video. The most comfortable is to split the screen to go copying and pasting commands, so let's go with it. We copy the commands to install the first necessary packages and paste them into the terminal. Then we install the XFCE for desktop. Finally, we download the script that I have prepared for you to launch the desktop with the audio running in a simple way. This script will be used to launch the desktop with Termix and not with Debian as we have seen in previous videos. Once downloaded the script, we give permissions of execution with the command that I show you. We run it, and it will automatically open the Termix X11 application. It will open a desktop a little different from the one you are seeing, but later I will show you how to configure it to your liking. Next, I will show you how to install Chrome. You have the commands described in the repository that we have seen previously. You only have to copy and paste them in the terminal. Note that to run Chromium, you have to use the no sandbox parameter or it will not run. As a tip to be able to launch it from the lower dock, you have to add also this parameter in the panel settings, otherwise it will fail. Here is how the process works. After installing the browser, let's see how to customize a little the whole environment by changing the theme, icons, and so on. I recommend this page where you can search for different themes for XFCE4. There is a lot of variety, so you can spend a good time to choose the one you like. To download a theme, simply select one, select the download tab, and wait for the countdown. Once downloaded, we only have to unzip it. In this case, I show you how to do it from the terminal in a more comfortable way. We open a terminal from the File Explorer, unzip the file, and copy the folders. The folders of themes, you have to paste them in the folder .themes. If it does not exist, you will have to create it yourselves. Once inside, we paste the folders that we have unzipped. We can repeat the process for the icons, in this case using the folder .icons, which also, if it does not exist, you will have to create it. To apply these changes, we have to go to the XFCE appearance settings, and inside we can choose the theme in the style tab and the icons in the icons tab. I recommend you to try several until you find the one you like the most. Finally, we are going to install a font to be able to show icons in the terminal. If you want to see how to customize the terminal, I leave below in the description a series of videos to install ZSH and PAL Level 10K theme. Once inside the Nerd Fonts page, we download the one we like the way it looks. As with the themes, once downloaded the file, we unzip it, in this case with the utility unzip, as it is a zip file. Then we copy all the files to the root that you can see in screen. When we copy the files to that path, automatically the system will recognize the fonts, but to apply them to the terminal, we will have to close it and reopen it. When we have restarted the terminal, we can go to the settings, to the appearance section, and there we will find all the fonts, including the one we just installed. I leave you the process of how to do it. Once you have copied all the files, you can delete them from the download folder. If we want to do it from the terminal, we can do it with the commands you are seeing. I leave the process in case anyone is interested in learning some basic Linux commands. Finally, we have to change the wallpaper. To do this, we move the images that we have downloaded to any folder. In my case, I have created a folder called Images where I will place all the files. Then from the desktop settings, we can select and search the images that we are going to use as wallpapers. Finally, I am going to change the icons by some that I like more, called Nordic, and I am going to make a preview of the desktop with all functional. If we go to YouTube, we can see how the performance is quite better than Debian using Proot Distro. However, it is still not as good as Edforma Native, and we can notice it in videos when we put them in high quality. I hope you liked this video. Any questions or suggestions for future videos are welcome, and don't forget to subscribe and share the videos.